Okay guys, I'm back with part two of making a platformer. Hopefully this video goes a little better than the last one. So last time we made the way of drawing things to a piece of paper or a canvas as you'd call it. So today, or this time, we are going to be creating a player object. So I'm going to do file new player.js, and if you're not using Node, you just come to your folders, do a new text, rename it and all that. So I'm going to come here to the player's object, and we're going to create a class. If you don't know how classes work, don't worry, hopefully it'll make sense soon. So I'm going to do class player. And then it's going to have curly brackets, constructor, brackets, curly brackets. And so what this is doing is it's creating a player. And this constructor is, you have to have a constructor inside of a class in order for it to work. A constructor is what happens, so everything in here is what happens as soon as you create this player. So at the bottom, we can create a player. So var will... We can't say player because this keyword is already used by this class. So we'll call it _player. We'll do capital player. So capital P player equals a new lowercase player. And this is going to take in an X and a Y value. So we'll say 50, 50, just some random numbers. So here, this takes in an X and a Y. Again, sorry for the lag. This dot X equals X. This dot Y equals Y. Okay, there we go. So, now, in the main event, we were drawing all of this. I can take this away for now. I'm just going from here. I'm just going to get rid of all that drawing stuff. Just get rid of it. We won't need it for now. Okay, so in the player object, well, we need a way of drawing this. So I can say draw, I can create a function for it that's called draw, brackets, curly brackets, and we'll say this player is going to draw, it'll be a square for now. So I want to make a variable called this.size, set it equal to 32, just kind of an arbitrary number. You can set it to whatever you want, play around with it later. In the draw event, I'm going to have this be a white square. So that'll be what the player looks like. So I'm going to say, what was the function we used last time? It was stroke color, and it's going to be 255. That's the color white, and this isn't going to have a fill, so I'll just say no fill, and then I'll do rectangle at this dot x, this dot y, and this needs a width and a height. So we'll do this dot size and this dot size. Okay, I can save that. Now, in the main, I can come here where this is where we had all the drawing before. So I'll just put it here for now. So player dot draw, and it's a capital P because we're calling this player, not the class player. Okay, now this isn't going to work, and hopefully you guys know why. If I refresh this, you get an error, player is not defined. So if I come here, well, but player should be defined, we created it right here. Well, in the index.html, we need to copy and we'll paste this same line of code. And I'll just call this player, because we need to, every time we create a new JavaScript file, we have to import it. So now if I come here and I refresh, well, here's the thing. I took out the drawing, the black background, and so the background is normally white, and the player we set to be white. So I'll just make him black for now. Save, and now if I come back to the browser, I refresh, there we go, we got a black square now. So now we know that's working. I'm going to put it back to white because we'll need it to be white. So, in every game, well, most games, well, Okay, I want to say all games. There is a form of a game loop, which essentially means you have some event or some loop. So it'll usually be a function, and we'll call it loop because that's what it is. And this happens every so often. In our case, it's going to happen every 30 frames per second. So var speed, we'll call it speed, we'll call it f target FPS equals 30. So that's how many frames per second we want to happen. So now, normally game loops are really fancy in the way they work, and they have this some weird math that work, but I want to make this easy. I don't like dealing with complex math like that because I'm not the best with it, so I'm gonna do something in JavaScript that I don't know how good it is for a game loop, but it works. So loop 1000. So I'm going to do this for now. Set interval means that we're going to have a function get called every so often. So the function loop gets called every 1000 milliseconds. So right now, this game loop is going to happen once every second, but we want it to happen 30 times a second. So the way we do that is we do 1000 divided by target FPS. And I might be lagging a little more right now than normal because I am right now having the last video get rendered. So sorry about that. So now this loop should happen I'm going to show you what it looks like with this, with just 1000. So once every second. So if I console.log hello and I come back here and I refresh, it should say every second. It's gonna say hello, hello, just once every second. Okay, but if I were to divide this by target FPS, and I come back here and I refresh, now it's happening 30 times a second, so very fast. Okay, so what we can do is we can take this player.draw and put it in here now instead. And along with that, we can have it every frame that we draw the background. So background, and we wanted the background, I think it was 25, 25, 25. I think that's the color we used. So I'll come here, I'll refresh this, and there we go. We now have the player being drawn and the background being drawn every frame. And it will stay updated. It'll like kind of flicker a little when we resize it. So in order to get around that, I'm going to copy this and put that there, the background, just so it doesn't flicker as much. The player should still flicker, but that's fine. What I could do instead, actually, take that out and call loop in here. And now nothing should flicker. So if I do this, there we go. Okay, so it's not flickering. Though, if in a real world sense, this is a bad idea, because if I were a user playing your game, I could do this and increase the frame, essentially increase the frames per second just by resizing it a bunch. But it'll be fine, I'm sure. If it worries you, then just draw the background. Or actually, I'll do something in a second. Here. We'll take care of it now because I'm sure some of you will want to know how. So I'm gonna have a function draw loop, and then function step loop. Whoops, I should probably step loop. So what's the difference between a step loop and a draw loop? Step loop is where all the math happens, where all the calculations happen. So, and the draw loop is just where we draw stuff to the screen. So things that will draw to the screen would be that. And right now we don't have anything in the step loop, but later we will. So I come to the loop, I'm gonna first call the step loop, and then I'm gonna call the draw loop. Now in here, instead of just calling loop, I'll call draw loop. So now, if I were to keep continuously resizing the screen, then everything gets redrawn, but nothing gets recalculated. calculated. Now, this is like a really minor thing that you don't need to worry about, really. I don't even know why I bothered with it. Most of you probably don't care. And most of you probably don't even know what I mean. I mean, I'm probably just confusing the hell out of a lot of you right now, but it's fine. You can leave it how it was before, or you can do what I just did. But hopefully I didn't hurt many of your brains. I know this can be confusing. Sometimes it confuses me too. Okay. So, what I want to do. So, right now our player has a draw event. Eventually, it's going to have a step event too. So, where all the logic happens. But, I might have more than one object than a player. I might also have walls, I might have trees, chests, things like that. All needs a draw event, all needs a step event. And I don't want to have to put them all here. So, what I'm going to do, I'm going to create an array called objects. And it's going to be an empty array for now. And instead of just going through every object that I create, like by hand, I'm going to loop through all the objects instead and call their draw event and call their step event. So for var I equals 0, I is less than objects.length I plus plus. And then I'm going to curly brackets. So I'm going to say if objects I dot draw, then objects I dot little lag dot draw. Okay, now I can get rid of this line code. So what is this doing? This is going to loop through every object in that array, and then it's going to check to make sure that object actually has a draw event. And if it has a draw event, then it will call that draw event. So now I can copy all of that, paste it there, indent it, and do the same thing for a step event. So make sure it has a step event, and if it does, call that step event. Okay, now in the player, now all I have to do is I have to say objects.push this. So whenever I create a new player, I'm going to push it into an array, into that object's array, so that it can then be drawn. So if I refresh, you should see apparently an error. Okay, let's look at this. Reference error. Objects is not defined. That is because that is plural when I'm... actually, that's plural. But here, object... whoa. I thought that was right. So if I go to index, player comes before main. So what am I doing wrong? I'm doing something silly. I am sure of it. So var objects, let me make sure I spelt it right. Objects.push this, and it is happening there. If I come here, so one thing you can do is if you're going to this console, if you go to the bottom, you can type in variables to see what they are. So there is, it says there's no variable called objects, which is weird because I very clearly defined this object's variable. So let me just see here. If I console.log here, objects, let's make sure that this is actually working. So if I come here and I refresh, did it even log it? It didn't even log it. So I'm going to pause it for a second and find out where my error is. So one thing to remember is that when you're creating variables or doing anything in programming, the order of which everything happens matters. So if we go to the index, first thing that happens is we do everything in the player script. So we come here, we look at this player script, and this is all happening before anything in main. So we come here, we create a class, and that's all fine. But then we create a player object down here. And when it's created, it calls this constructor. And in the constructor, it pushes, it tries to call this object, or tries to call this variable objects, but because nothing in main has been called yet, this objects variable does not exist yet. So I'm going to take this line of code, I'm going to cut it out, go to main, and I'm going to put it underneath where I define objects. So I'm going to save both of these. But another thing is right here. So we have this window.onResize gets called. So in the onResize function, we have this draw loop. So if we come down and look at draw loop is also going to try and call this objects variable, which doesn't exist yet. So I need to take this and also move that down. And I don't know what the hell this was. What the heck, player? Okay, there we go. I had to get rid of some stuff there. That was weird. Okay, so there we go. Now everything should hopefully be in the right order. Okay, there we go. We got a player. It is being drawn. We're all good. If I come back, if it'll let me come back. Okay, I was pushing the wrong button, no wonder. So if I go to player, I'm just gonna do something. I'm gonna say this dot y plus equals 5, just for a test. If I come here and I refresh, there we go. The player is moving downwards now. Okay, so we have it working. I can get rid of this. So we haven't been in this for a while, so let's add something else. Let's say walls, because the platformer needs walls. So we're going to create a new file, call it walls, or this one word, just, or not plural, wall.js. Remember, anytime we need a new file, we have to put it in here. So wall.js, come back here, it's going to be a class wall, needs a constructor. Okay, and it's going to need an x and a y value. I can already tell you that. Okay, so this dot x equals 32. Well, this dot x equals x. Sorry, this dot y equals y. This dot size equals 32. So it's pretty much actually. You know what? I could have just copied this because of all this basic stuff is pretty much the same. So far, everything's the same. It's going to be a. It's going to draw a white rectangle or a white square. Have the same size, it's going to be an object, all of that stuff, except I want to be able to keep track of all the walls. So before, we're keeping track of every single object in general, so that could be players, walls, trees, and all that, but I want to keep track of, for now, all the walls. So var walls equals a blank array, so I can say walls.push this. Just like we were doing in objects, but now we're going to push walls. Okay. So let's start with something simple, like if I come to the main, let's create a bunch of walls. How about that? So I'm going to do this right here, I suppose. I'll do it right here. This is where my create event is going to be essentially. So this is right here. Okay. So for var I equals 0, I is less than, we'll do 32 walls, I plus plus, again, arbitrary number. I'm going to say a new wall at the position. So the x is going to be I times 32. And the y is going to, the y is going to be 200, I guess. So if I come back here and I refresh, there we go. We have created a long line of walls just along the bottom. If I come back here, I'm going to increase that number actually to 400. You know what I kind of want to do? I'm going to go to the wall, and I'm just going to say stroke size 2. That seems like a good number. If I come here, but you're going to see the player stroke size goes to 2 as well. But that's fine. I kind of like this. I like it that way anyway. It's a little easier to see. Okay, so I suppose we could add some interactivity, I guess you could say. So I'm gonna create a new file. I know we're creating a bunch of files, but that's part of programming. You don't need a lot of files. You could do everything in one file, but having more files makes things a lot more organized. So I'm gonna do keys.js. Why am I calling it keys? Because it's a good name. So keys.js. And right now I'm not going to actually do key presses. I'm going to do var mouse x and mouse y. If it'll stop lagging. Okay, mouse x, I'm going to set it equal to 0, var mouse y equals 0. So for now it'll be 0 and 0. But it's going to change in a second. And let me just double check that I do this right, because again, I don't want to get any errors. Document. So this is document dot on mouse new equals on, or I'll call it on mouse move. Oh, actually, we'll do a function equals a function parentheses brackets, and I believe this takes in a variable called event. Okay, wait, 1 second. Sorry about that. I could have swore I heard my phone vibrating or something, but I guess I'm just going crazy. Okay, so where was I? Okay, so document.onMouseMove. So this is, well, if you look at main for a second, we have this thing, window.onResize equals function. And this looks the same. So this is saying whenever the mouse moves, call this function. But what is this event thing? Well, this event allows us to see what's going on with the mouse. So I could say mouse x equals event dot client x, which essentially gives us where did the mouse move to. So where is the mouse? So mouse y equals event dot client y. So there we go. Whenever the mouse moves, it's going to update the x and the y position of these variables. So I can go to the player just as a test. I'm going to give this a step event. I'm going to say this dot x equals mouse x and this dot y equals mouse y. Now if I come here and I refresh it, it moves to the mouse. Okay, perfect. Now I figured this is going to be a little more complicated. So, but I think it'll be fine. I was going to save it for another video, but I don't know if it's complicated enough to warrant its own video. So what we're going to do is we're going to do key presses and stuff like that. So we'll start with the most complicated one, which is var key press. And so this is going to be a kind of an array, so actually an object of all the keys that exist, and it's going to record whether or not they have been pressed, not are being pressed, but were pressed. So every frame, so every second there's 30 frames. So that's what frames are, frames per second. There's 30 frames in a second. So the moment you push a button, like the moment you push the A button, then that variable will be set to true. But then the frame right after, it's set to false. So it's only the moment you press it. There'll be another one, var key down equals this, which happens as every frame that the key is down. So every frame, as long as I'm holding down that key. Hopefully this is making sense. And then there's one last one we'll make, which is release, which is the moment you release the key. But for now, we'll just start with the hardest one, key press. Okay, so funny enough, we'll need a temporary variable. So I'm going to do capital T, key press, so temporary. And maybe there's a simpler way of doing this. I don't know. I hope there is. I wish there was. If there is, someone should tell me. So what I'm going to do. So in reality, there's 255 keys, you could say. I mean, there's actually more, well, less, I mean, but if you look at an ASCII chart, which I'm not going to get into too much, I'll get into a little bit, there's 255 keys. So I'm going to say var I equals 0, I is less than 255, so we're going to do 255 iterations. And if I, okay, there we go. So an ASCII value essentially says, oh, this is an example, this isn't actually right, but like, let's say the number 0 is the letter A, and whoops, did not want to do that. The number one is the letter B, and so on and so forth. And that's essentially what it's doing. That's what an ASCII value essentially is. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to set key press, and I want to set some value equal to false. So by default, all of them are going to be set to false. By default, we're not pushing anything. And so we need to convert the number into a letter. And the way you do that is you say, so I'll say var l equals string dot from car, and I believe it's car, is it a car or character? No, it's car. Car is short for character. Car code I. And this turns a number, which is I, into a letter essentially. So I can say key press L equals false, and then I can say T temporary key press L equals false. So I'm going to set all of them to be by default false. Okay, so now there's another kind of document thing, document function that we need to deal with. Document.onKeyPress equals function E. Event. I think we can call this event still. I could be wrong. We might have to call it E. I just hit my knuckles. That hurt. Okay, so var key. So what key are we pressing? Equals. I'm going to say event.key, which is the letter of what. So this is actually the letter. This isn't a number. This isn't the ASCII value. This is the physical letter. But I'm going to say dot to uppercase. There. So dot to uppercase. And this is because, like, the number 0 might be the letter A, but as we go down to like number 27 or something, then we get into where we have capital letters. And so this is going to essentially make, even if, so if you are holding shift and press a letter, like if I'm holding shift and press the letter A, there's not going to be, I don't want there to be difference if I'm doing that versus if I'm just regularly pressing the letter A. So I'm just going to set everything to capital just so that there's no confusion, just whether I'm holding shift or not holding shift, it's all the same. Okay, so now I'm going to say if not T key press key. So this is saying if this is false, then first off, we're going to set it to true. Temporary key press key equals true, and T key. Well, no. Sorry. Just regular key press key equals true. Okay. There we go. So now it's being pressed. However, I need one more event, and I think that'll be it. This is going to be function key end. And you can call this whatever you want, but I'm going to call it key end. Now I'm going to do a for loop for var I equals 0, same size for loop for var I equals 0, I is less than 255, I plus plus. So we're looping through every key again, and I'm going to say, well, actually, you know what I can do? This might be a little more confusing or advanced if you don't know JavaScript very well, but I can say for var I in key press. Yeah, okay, so yeah, for var I in key press, then I'm going to say key press I equals false, and actually, no, nothing yet. That's it. That should be it, at least. Okay, so there we go. Now we're getting key presses. So if I go to player, right here I have this. So let me just comment this out for a second. So now it won't. So if you don't know what comments do, just put a slash slash in front of something, and anything after this won't do anything with the code at all. Okay, but anyway, so if key press dot, I'm going to say the W key. So if we press that key, then I'm going to say this dot Y plus equals 64. Okay. So we come here. Hopefully this works. So I push. Oh. So it's okay. So as soon as I press the W key, first of all, it starts increasing, but it never stops, which means I don't know why. It's because we forgot this needs to actually be called. So if we go to the main and we go to the loop here at the very end, I'm gonna say key end there. So that's what that is. So at the end of the loop, at the end of each frame, it's going to reset those variables or reset that variable. So if I come here and I refresh now, if I push W, I jump 64. If I press W again, it's not doing anything. That's because if you go to keys, T key press never gets set back to false. Okay, well that comes next. Document dot on key up, which is another function, whoops, equals a function with an event. It's the same as the one above, except this happens as soon as you release a key. So now this one, oh, I think simpler. So I'm gonna say var key equals same thing, event dot key dot to uppercase. There we go. Now I need to say t key press key equals false. So the temporary key is set to false. So once you release it, that temporary key will go to false. I think I said that three times. So now if I come here, if I press W, I can press W again, press W again, just keep pressing. But if I hold it, doesn't do anything. Just only as soon as I press it does that get called. Okay. Let's go now to the easier ones. Yes, I promise they're a lot easier. So var key release, release. I think that's how it's spelled. I could easily be wrong. So the first thing I need to do, I need to default it, set it to false. So key release L equals false in that first thing. So that'll just, yeah. Here in the key up, I'm gonna set this to true. Key release key equals true. And then here at the key end, I'm gonna set it back to false. Key release L or I equals false. So if I come to, it's not gonna notice, you're not gonna notice as much because the way the video works, but in your code, this should work. So if I refresh, if I press W, it doesn't do anything, but as soon as I release it, the player jumps down. Okay. One last one. So this is going to be key. I'm gonna re So this is actually already done. This one's the really easy one because this is done. Instead of calling this T key press, I'm just gonna call this key down. And anywhere that you said T key press, I'm just gonna replace it with key down. I'm pretty sure this will work. So now if I go to the player and I say key down, this should get called while I'm holding it. So let me set that to something smaller, like 4. So if I hold the W key, I just constantly move down now. Now, if you're probably wondering, why didn't I just call it key down right from the get-go instead of going through the trouble of calling it temporary key down? And that's because I didn't think about that and that that could work until halfway through. And then I realized, wow, I'm so stupid. I could have just called that key down. That would have been the exact same thing. In my other code, I used both T key down and, or T, I used both the temporary variable and the key down variable. Sorry, I was a little stupid there, but I figured it out while programming. So now you get to see the better result. So there we go. So next time we're going to be working on a little bit of gravity, and which is, don't worry, that's a lot easier than it sounds. But we're also going to be doing collisions, which that's the hard part. A little complicated with collisions, but I'm sure together we can get through it. But until next time, see ya.